Hi, I'm Fraser Douglas, the avid tent camper. Ava and I just received this new Copper Canyon LX8 person tent, and we've set it up in our backyard. And so I thought that we would give you a little tour of our new tent. Over the past 52 years, I have owned and camped in over 25 different tents, and two of these tents have been Eureka brand. One of these Eureka tents was this headquarters six-person tent, and the other was this Timberline four-person tent. Like every other tent model, each of these Eureka models had certain features that I liked and certain features that I did not like. One of the things that I especially liked about Eureka tents is that they had an outstanding customer service department, and they repaired for free one of my old tents that was damaged as a result of my own negligence. About 10 years ago, I began to carefully examine the many family tent models that were available for sale, trying to determine the ones that were best suited for each particular camp situation. And I concluded that the Eureka Copper Canyon was the best family camping tent for hot summer weather. And so I've been wanting to buy one for at least a year. When I discovered that Eureka had just improved this tent for 2020 and that Moose Jaw was offering the LX 8-person model for much less than its suggested retail price, I immediately ordered one. When the tent arrived at my house, my first impression was that this is much smaller than I expected and it will be very easy to pack. But when I picked the package up, I was surprised that it was much heavier than it looked. The tent weighs over 31 pounds, and as I soon discovered, most of that weight is due to the 10 heavy fiberglass and steel poles. Like all other tents, the stakes that came with the tent may work okay in soft ground, but they're useless here in the South, where most of our tent pads and tent sites are hard-packed crushed gravel. So I just pack them away and will depend upon these heavy-duty stakes that we have packed in our tool bag. This tent does not come with a ground cloth, but that's no big deal because you can easily make one from an economically priced poly tarp. So I just ordered a heavy-duty 10x12 tarp, folded the long edge back a foot, and glued it down to make a 9x12-foot tarp, and then added some corner grommets. As already mentioned, the tent has 10 heavy poles. There are 3 fiberglass roof support poles, 4 steel corner support poles, 2 steel center support poles, and 1 thin fiberglass front door awning support pole. Although the tent packs into a very nice little carry bag, I've always found these bags to be too small, and so I pack my tents, along with their ground cloths, in larger duffel bags. There's no need to show the setup of this tent because Eureka has already posted a good video on YouTube showing the setup, but I do want to summarize the setup steps and emphasize a couple of points that may not have been emphasized enough in that video. First of all, you have to position your ground cloth where you want your tent to set and then spread out the tent. Second, you have to find the front door by finding the 2 brass grommets and the side attachment strips, and then orient your tent so that the front door faces in the direction you want. Third, you have to slide the fiberglass ceiling support poles through their sleeves, and then insert each end of each roof support pole into its respective plastic eave hub. This step can be difficult, and we found it was helpful if one person went inside the tent and pushed up on the ceiling while the other person inserted the support rods into their plastic eave hubs. We also discovered
that if you insert the center tan pole first, as suggested in the setup video, then it sits on top of the other two diagonal sleeves and makes it hard to get the diagonal rods through the sleeves. So next time, we'll put the diagonal rods in first and the center tan rod last. Next, you have to place the four black steel corner support poles in place and then put the two tan center support poles in place. Next, you have to find the front door of the rainfly, attach the front two corners to the corner support poles, pull the rainfly over the top of the tent, and then attach the two back corners to the back corner support poles. You'll want to insert the thin fiberglass front door awning pole into its respective grommets. And finally, since this is a big tent with steep vertical sidewalls, you'll want to stake it down and guy it out every time you set it up. So let me mention a few things that we like about this tent. First of all, I really like the overall structure of this tent, which is a variation of the old umbrella tents that were so strong. The 10-foot by 13-foot floor, along with the near vertical walls, make this the most spacious tent I have ever owned.
It's like a small motel room.
There's plenty of room for a family of six, or four large cots, or two people with tables and chairs for relaxation. The 7-foot plus ceiling height gives me plenty of room to stand up and walk around inside the tent. And the older I get, the more important that is. I really like the fabric rather than mesh sidewalls and windows that can be opened for ventilation or closed to hold in heat. I really like those beefy poles because it looks like they will last forever. I like the fact that it has several ceiling rings that allow us to hang our light, clothesline, or anything else that we want from the top of the tent. I like the fact that the tent does not have vestibules, which I consider to be unnecessary and requiring excessive setup space. I like the two power ports, one on each side, that allows us to bring an electric cord into the tent without having to zip and unzip the door. I'm also happy that the tent has two large doors. And I am reminded of the story of the man that opened his front door of his tent to go out one night and found a skunk in his vestibule. But since his tent had two doors, he was able to zip his front door closed and go out the back door. The guy lines are made from good quality 3mm cord, but I don't particularly care for this plastic slide, and so I just tie taut line hitches on my guy lines instead. I should also add that the tent comes with a room divider, which we'll never use, and four mesh pockets, which we will rarely use. And finally, both Ava and I really like the color of this tent. And now let me mention a couple of limitations that we have noticed. First of all, it's a little more difficult to set up than any other tent that we have owned, but I think it will get easier the more times we practice. Second, although that mesh roof will be nice on hot nights, I'm afraid it will be a little too cool on cool nights. I wish that it had roof panels that could be closed up there. I'm going to try to hang a space blanket up there to help hold in some of the heat. A third limitation is the floor of the tent is thinner than the floor of any other tent that I've owned, and it looks like it could be easily damaged. But we always put a ground cloth down under our tent and a carpet on top of the floor, and so that should protect it. A fourth limitation is that the large vertical sidewalls will make this tent much more vulnerable to damage from storms and high winds. So we need to watch the weather forecast before deciding to pack it for a trip. And finally, on this first setup, the front wall is so tight that it's difficult to zip the door through that curved corner on the upper right side. I'll look for ways to try to make that zip a little bit easier. In sum, we really like this tent, and we hope that we're able to take many camping trips in the next few years in it.
Well, I hope that you've enjoyed this little video, and I hope that you've learned a little bit about the new Copper Canyon LX8 tent.
For more information about family camping tents available this year,
and about other camping equipment, please visit my website, Modern Tent Camping. A link is provided in the description below.
Remember, take more trips, travel further, visit more attractions, and save money. Go tent camping.